I'm gonna win!
No, you're not!
Remember Finding Nemo, the movie that introduced us to clownfish?
Love you, Dad.
Dory, the absent-minded sidekick, now has her own movie. But marine conservationists, they're not excited. They're actually kind of worried. This right here is a blue tang, the real-life Dory. They only live on coral reefs in the South Pacific. But before we get to her story, let's talk about Nemo, the clownfish. When Finding Nemo came out, well, okay, I'll let Karen tell you.
I'm Karen Burke de Silva. I'm a marine biologist and a conservation biologist here at Flinders University of South Australia.
So what happened with Finding Nemo?
After the release of Finding Nemo, we found that there was quite a big increase in the number of people that wanted a clownfish as a pet. With the increase in demand, it did have an increase in captive breeding, but it also meant that more fish were being taken from the wild. And in fact, some places there's been so much overcollecting that clownfish have gone locally extinct.
Oh, so captive breeding seems like the way to go. Back to Dory, the blue tang. If her movie has the same effect as Nemo's, moviegoers are sure to want to buy a blue tang of their own.
But there's a problem.
And you are?
My name is Matt DiMaggio. I'm an assistant professor at the University of Florida Tropical Aquaculture Laboratory.
Okay, Matt, so what's the problem?
Clownfish are relatively easy to raise in captivity. But up until now, no one has raised blue tangs in captivity. Blue tang larvae are inherently difficult to raise. They have a very small mouth when they hatch out, so the food particles that we have to offer them are much smaller and much more difficult to raise. The best success we've had to date is using a zooplankton called a copepod. The copepods that we grow here only eat live microalgae. So you now have to grow live microalgae to feed to the copepods.
Basically, raising blue tangs so far is really, really hard, which means
100% of blue tang are currently being taken from the wild for the aquarium trade. Most collectors in Australia will use very careful collecting measures. In other parts of the world, Southeast Asia, they are using cyanide still to collect aquarium fish.
Ugh, that's not good. But there's hope. Matt and his team are working hard to breed blue tang successfully.
There's only one other tang species, the yellow tang, that's ever been raised in captivity before. We're hoping that the blue tang will be the second.
All right, so until they do, when little Johnny says he wants a Dory, perhaps the better choice, for now at least, is to stick to the blue betta. Or a goldfish.